Hello everyone, very good afternoon to one and all. Welcome back to the Vichita Rajkumar online classes. Today I'm going to give the notes in the practical regard in the subject of the primary healthcare nursing for the MPHW first year students. So today I would like to give the complete notes of practical regard, like a section 1, section 2. Okay, so this is so what you have to write, this practical manual or practical regard, this what I am telling, those instructions you have to follow, and you have to write the practical record, what I am providing the content. Okay, so let's we see the one by one. Section 1, so list out the types of bed making and explain the procedure of unoccupied bed, explain the procedure of vital signs, explain the different routes of drug administration, and briefly explain the procedure of intramuscular injection. Okay, fourth question is deleted for who are going to write this year examinations. Okay, and explain the principles, uses, and types of bandages. And so this is the only for the 70% syllabus, 30% deleted content for the who are going to write this year examinations, like 2022 batch. It's clear, na? So remaining all the questions will be there only. So due to the corona, some of the syllabus is reduced. So those students no need to write the in the section 1, fourth question no need to write. Section 2, ninth question is no need to write. It's clear, na? Okay, so section 3, 15th question is no need to write. So today I'm going to give the notes in the primary healthcare nursing for the MPHW first year students. Let me see the one by one. Okay, in first question, section 1, practical record or practical manual. In that, first question is types of bed making and procedure of unoccupied bed. So this is a spelling mistake will be there. Even though you have to correct it, ma. Okay, so here the procedure. Okay, PROCEDURE procedure. Okay, types of bed making, procedure of unoccupied bed. So this is a bed, unoccupied bed. Okay, to make a bed which is comfortable and safe for the patient, need economical in time and effort. This is the equipment for cleaning the bed and all. Okay, so this is a tray containing this, all the things you have, just you have to go. This is for the writing purpose. I am going to giving the notes like a writing purpose. It's clear, na? So procedure and everything you have to make it right. So next coming to, so as usual you have to try the points. If you want, take the screenshot and you can make it notes. Okay, 5th to 6th, already this question is yesterday I have given these notes, so that is the reason I am not reading entire content. Okay, next one is the okay, everything. So next coming to the okay, up to here, like a procedure of what I am telling here, like a see here. Types of bed making and procedure of unoccupied bed. So this is the first what we have to write. First you have to write the types of bed making. Okay, so types of bed making means you have to write the, so I will give the like a types of bed making, like a flow chart. I will show you the flow chart for you people. Okay, see here. So this is a flow chart for you people. See here, like this you can write it. Okay, types of beds. Okay, types of beds you can write, written beds. So routine beds is again divided into two, like a occupied, unoccupied bed and simple occupied bed. Sorry, simple unoccupied bed. Okay, next, simple unoccupied bed is again divided into like cardiac bed, orthopedic bed. So this all comes under like this again. Okay, simple unoccupied bed is again divided into cardiac bed, orthopedic bed, admission bed, divided bed, amputation bed, and okay, plaster Paris beds. Okay, it's clear now. Okay. Okay, sorry, ma. So types of beds, na, routine beds and special beds. Routine beds is second divided into occupied bed and unoccupied, only this role. But whereas in special beds is second divided into this one. So this is what I am telling before, now this is no need to write and all. So only simple beds, routine beds are two types, occupied and unoccupied. And special beds is again divided into this way. Okay. Cardiac bed, orthopedic bed, operation bed, these are all the things. This is a types of bed. Okay, types of beds. but the question is types of bed making. So types of bed making also same thing only. So we have to make the patient, we have to make the bed for the patient. So in order to relieve the comfort, in order to give the relief, in order to reduce the discomfort and everything, that is the reason we have to provide the we have to make the bed for the patients. It's clear now. Okay, this is the first point. You have tried this one. At least you have to try to write the like a, so this flow chart you have to write, and one more what you have to write, at least we have to write that this is the bed making principles. Okay, this first point you can write it. Bed making is act of preparing a comfortable and suitable bed for the hospital patient by nurses using a specific skills for various purposes. It is a usual done by two nurses, and there are various types of which are. Okay, first point, types of bed making. In that first what you have to write, this you have to write first point, first page. Okay, principles of bed making. When you are doing a bed making also, we have to follow some of the principles. Okay, in this, okay, already I have given, no, like a simple bed and all. Okay, first question in practical record, first question what you have to write, you have to write the introduction about the bed making and principles types of bed making and various types of bed making. Okay, and principles of bed making. So this is first paper. Second paper what you have to write, starting I have told, no. So this is the second paper. Okay, this one is you have to write second paper. So I have finished the section one first question. Types of bed making I have told, I have given notes, and procedure of unoccupied bed also I have heard. Okay, it's clear na? Okay, first question completely I have finished it. Okay, so this is all the admission bed, fracture bed. If you want, you can write the notes also, otherwise no need. Okay, cardiac bed and all, these are the types of bed making. Okay, they didn't ask explain the procedure of different types of bed. They have only list outing the types of bed making. Only you can list out the cardiac, operative, fracture, this is all things you can write. It's clear, na? Okay, operative, okay, bed occupied and everything you can write. Okay, so next coming to the second question. So second question is the, so here the second question is the, okay, temperature, pulse, okay, temperature, oral, pulse, respiration, group technique, and these are all the things are. Okay, second question is a procedure of vital signs. Okay, first question I have finished, no, like a first question is the like a types of bed making and procedure of unoccupied bed. So second one is a procedure of vital signs. So temperature, vital signs are nothing but the vitals are very very important, necessary for the human boy, for human beings to survival in the world. So that's a very very important, necessary and essential. Okay, by following these signs, we can able to identify the this particular patient is live or alive. It's clear. Okay, temperature, pulse, respiration, and BP. These are all the things that we can call as a vital signs. It's clear. Okay, so here the what is the purpose of vital signs? Why we have to check the, why we have to do the procedure of vital signs? To determine the patient's temperature, pulse, respiration. Next one, to aid in diagnosis, to identify the diagnosis of the abnormal condition, okay, and to prevent the complications. This is the main purpose of the, for doing the vital signs procedure. Next coming to equipment. What are the equipment we have to carry? So, a tray containing, so what is the main purpose of to carry the tray? So why we have to carry means to assemble all the equipment in a convenient way in order. That is the reason we have to carry the tray. Three jars, glasses, containing 5% Dettol or 5% Savlon or Lysol, 1 in 40% or 2.5%. Covered container or glass with a fresh or gas for clean thermometers. And next 12 thermometers. Covered container of dry, not Rema. So dry. Okay, covered container of dry cotton swabs. Swabs, spelling mistakes will be this, swabs, not swats. Swabs, okay, this one, swabs is clear, na? Okay, covered container of dry cotton swabs, okay, and next covered container of soapy swabs, next kidney tray and paper bag and TPR chart, okay. So these are all the things we have to carry. These are all the equipments, a covered container of cotton swabs to clean the thermometer before checking, after checking, we have to clean the thermometer. That is the reason we have to carry the cotton swabs. And after checking the thermometer, after checking the temperature of the patients, we have to clean the thermometer from the soapy swabs. And where we have to throw the this cotton bag, we have to use a kidney tray with the paper bag. So after checking, we have to enter into the TPR chart. That is the reason we have to carry this all the things. So let me see the procedure. So keep the tray at a convenient place in the ward. Okay. If you want, you can you can maintain the running notes. Remove the 1 thermometers. Check the answer. We have to. At a time, we cannot take the temperature of the 3 or 4 patients. Only once we can check the temperature of the patients. Okay, so that is the reason we have to take the already we have kept a tray in the tray, like four thermometer glasses will be there in that first. I will show you. This is a tray in this tray, like a TPR glasses will be there, like in this one and this one. Okay, I will show you. Okay, glass. Okay, so this is the first two thermometers. We have to keep the labeling thermometers in this only one, two, three. First thermometer, we have to write the labeling thermometer. Second one is a one, second, third one is a two, fourth one is the like a three, like this. We have so here the like a plastic containers. In this, we have in plastic containers, one plastic container, we have to keep the cotton swab. Second one is the soapy solutions, soapy swabs. And third one is a kidney tray with the paper bag. We have to keep like this. It's clear, no? Okay. So here, kidney tray. Okay, like this. Thermometers, glasses and all. It's clean. So when you are ready for the tray for checking of the patient, the temperature, at a time we have to clean thermometers, we have to keep it. So in each TPR glasses, we have to keep down the cotton. So why we have to keep the down here means to prevent the breakage of the thermometers. It's clear, no? So this is the only we have to keep the gauze pieces under the thermometer glasses. Okay, so here in this 3/4, we have to prepare the 5% Dettol solution. We have to pour up to 3/3. Okay, up to third, we have to pour the thermometers 3. Okay, in fresh thermometers, we have to keep here in this. If we want to check the thermometer of the patient, we have to take one thermometer from the first thermometer glasses. All the thermometer glasses labeling will be there. In that, we have to take thermometers after checking where we have to only these 3 glasses containing the Dettol solutions. Only these 3 glasses having the 5% Dettol solution. Okay, it's clear now for disinfection thermometers. Only this one is having only clean and neat thermometers. So this the first TPR glasses used for the ready for the taking the temperature of the patients. Only without Dettol solution will be there in the first TPR glass. And fourth one is 5% Dettol solution may have. So after checking the thermometer of the patient, we have to keep it here. So how many we have to, so each thermometers we have to keep after checking the temperature. First TPR glass, we have to take the thermometer from the thermometers TPR glasses, and we have to go for the bedside area, and we have to check the thermometer, and again we have to come back to the, and after checking, we have to clean the thermometer from the stem to bulb, and we have to where we have to keep first labeling will be there, no? In that we have to keep the thermometer. In that first, second, third labeling we have kept, no? In that we have to keep the thermometer. So how many already you have finished one, and again you have finished third patient also, you have checked fourth patient also, you have checked. So only 4 thermometers we have to keep in only each thermometer glass. Already we have kept thermometers, 12 thermometers we have to keep. So each thermometer after finishing, we have to keep only 4 thermometers only we have to keep. Okay, again if 15 13 members are there, already we finished the 12, again one patient is ready. So what we have to do, already in first labeling thermometer will be there, no? In that we have to take the all thermometers in first thermometer glass. We have to go to sink area, we have to clean thermometers in the running water, and again we have to keep the thermometers glasses. It's clear, na? Okay, so instead of telling, if I show, no, you may get it. Okay, if I get time, I will tell you. Okay, so here that see one by one. So always we have to keep it one thing before checking the thermometer to the patient. We have to clean the thermometer from the this is a before checking So before checking the thermometer, we have to clean the thermometer from the, this is the bulb. So this is the stem. This part is we can call it as a stem, this part is we can call it as a bulb. So before checking the temperature, we have to clean the thermometer from the bulb to stem. From stem to bulb. It's clear, na? So before checking, we have to clean here. After checking, like this, we have to follow. This is the only one principle you have to keep in mind. Okay, remove the thermometers, check the mercury level, reads below 95 degrees Fahrenheit or 35 degrees centigrade, okay? So before checking the thermometer, what we have to see, we have to keep the eye level, we have to read the reading, like a 95 or 35 degrees is there or not. Okay, remove the thermometer and we have to remove the thermometer from the TPR glass. And we have to read the readings below 95 degrees Fahrenheit or 35 degrees Celsius, okay? Remove two cotton dry swabs and place thermometer beneath the tongue of the two patients at a time. So, not two patients, we count that one. Actually, the rule is, one patient is enough. It is very serious. You can manage with the two patients, okay? Okay, next, place thermometer beneath the tongue of the two patients at a time. Keep the hand across the abdomen. Count the respiration and pulse for 1 minute each for the first patient. Remove the thermometer from the second patient's mouth and wipe, read, count the pulse and respirations, record TPR. Okay, temperature, pulse, respiration. Discard the swabs into paper bag and shake the mercury level below 92 degrees Fahrenheit, 35 degrees centigrade. Remove the two swabs and clean thermometers. Place the used thermometers. Okay, wait ma, just okay, first what we have to do, remove the thermometer from the TPR glass. We have to check the readings, whether it is there below 95 or 35 or not. Okay, again we have to take the two cotton swabs and we have to clean the thermometers from the, so here we have to write this one more point, this you can write it, this also, okay, right? But in this, after taking the two cotton swabs from the container, what we have to do, we have to clean, we can write it more, clean the thermometer from the bulb to stem. And after that, place the thermometers beneath the tongue of the patients at a time. Okay, and again, we have to wait for 3 minutes. After that, we have to, until 3 minutes, what we have to do, so during these 3 minutes, we have to place the patient arm over the patient chest area, and again you have to place your hand over the patient hand, and you have to observe the respiration, and after that we have to count the pulse. So within these 3 minutes we have to check the temperature, pulse, respiration. Okay, when you have finished the 3 minutes, we have to take out the thermometers from the site of the temperature checking, and we have to clean the thermometer from the bulb to stem to bulb, and again we have to clean the thermometer with the soapy swab, and we have to throw it in the kitchen tray with the paper bag. It's clear, no? And after that we have to keep the thermometers in first label, already have kept, no, label 1, okay? In that total solution will be there, no? In that we have to keep the TPR glass, okay? How many you can keep thermometers in each glass? Only 4 thermometers only we have to, we have to keep the thermometers for disinfecting the thermometers. For disinfection of thermometers, how long we can keep? At least 15 to 20 minutes enough for the disinfection of thermometers. If you want, already we have finished the 12 thermometers. Again, patient is ready for temperature checking and all. What we have to do, after finishing 12 to 20 minutes, we have to take out all the thermometers from the Dettol solution. We have to go to the sink area. We have to clean it. And again, we have, after cleaning thermometers in the running water, we have to keep it over the clean thermometer. First thermometers labeling will be there, no? In that nothing will be there, only plain thermometers only will be there, no? In that we have to keep the thermometer. This is the procedure actually will be there. Okay, so count the respiration pulse for 1 minute. Remove thermometer from the second patient's mouth and wipe, read, count the pulse rate. So discard the two swabs into paper bag. Okay, mercury line, we have to check it. Remove the two swabs and clean thermometer. Place the used thermometers in the container. Okay, place the used thermometers in the okay, container. Repeat the procedure for the rest of the patients by putting next 4 thermometers in the second container and the last 4 thermometers in the third container. Okay, so when the 12 thermometers were used, okay, already we have carried 12 thermometers now. So when the 12 thermometers were used, remove the thermometers from the first container, wash them under the cold running water with the bulb thermometers pointing downwards.
Okay, so place them in the clean container. Empty the kidney tray. Wash, rinse, and replace the tray. Refill the containers with the swabs and solutions. This is a okay. It's clear, na? First we have to remove thermometer. We have to take out the thermometers from the clean thermometers. Okay, we have to clean thermometers from the bulb to stem. Okay, we have to take out. We have to take the one cotton swabs. Okay, we have to place under the tongue of the patients. Okay, and we have to take out, and after that within 3 minutes we have to check the pulse respiration. Okay, and after that we have to again we have to keep eye level, we have to read the reading. Okay, and after that we have to keep in your mind like a reading how much will be there, and after that we have to clean the thermometers with the soapy solution. After we have to keep it in the like a Dettol solution thermometers. It's and after that when you are after keeping thermometers in the Dettol solution, we have to write the documentations in the TPR chart. Okay, so routinely they have this the procedure of the TPR vital signs and all. Okay, so this is the notes. Keep thermometers in the mouth for 3 minutes. When more accurate temperature is desired, keep thermometers for 5 to 7 minutes actually, but 3 minutes is enough. Use thermometers must be kept in the disinfectant solution not section, na? So this is the solution, disinfect solution, SOLUTION, disinfect solution for not less than 15 minutes. Okay, already I have told you 15 to 20 minutes is enough for the disinfection of the thermometers in the Dettol solution. Not more than 2 students should use thermometers tray at a time, should not use single ones. We have to use the disinfect solution must be changed every 12 hours. Wash the containers with soap and water, rinse, and add fresh solution to the containers. Rectal thermometer rectal temperature is recorded by writing circular 0. If you check the temperature by using the rectal method, we can use circular, and oral temperature by this dot. Axillary temperature is indicated by writing letter A near the dot, A dot. Okay, so dot indicates the oral, circle indicates the rectal, and axillary indicates A. Okay, it's clear, na? So dotted the line item and temperature graph sheet indicates variations in temperature with the rigor and any cold sponge or other variations to be recorded in the nurse's record or notes. So use boiled cold water to repeat to prepare for the Dettol solutions. We should not use the hot, only you have to use the boiled like a cold water to, okay. The next question is already we have finished the second question. Third question, the different routes of drug administration and procedure of intramuscular injection. So this is third question. Administration of drugs via the intramuscular, okay, route requires nurses to possess with thought and the exercise of professional judgment, as well as an understanding of anatomy and physiology and knowledge of the technique. Drugs administered via the intramuscular route are deposited deep into the muscle tissue. Okay, so here the decision, first we have to see about the procedure of intramuscular injections. Okay, in the intramuscular injection, an intramuscular injection is an when medication is injected deep into the muscle. Intramuscular injection is nothing but the we have to inject the medication into deep into the muscles. Intramuscular injection is the injection of a substance directly into muscles. Okay, a method of administering medication directly into muscle tissue. A route of drug administration is the process by which a drug fluid, poison or other substance is brought into contact with the body. On the basis of the local and systematic routes can be broadly classified, divided into purposes of intramuscular injections. Okay, it is a simple and accessible. Absorption of drug is more rapid. Slightly irritate drug can be given. Okay, so this is if the patient is not subsiding with the problem, the next alternation is the IM. Again, the patient is not subsiding with the IM injection also, again they will go for the IV injections. It's clear, na? So this is a see here. So this is a the needle should be inserted at 90 degree angle and penetrate the muscle layer. Like this we have to give that. So this is the skin. So this is the skin will be there in this deep into, not like this 90 degree angle. Like this we have to, how we will catch the pin, like this we have to give the injection. This is the sites of IM injections. Okay, we have to draw the table diagram. It's clear na? Okay, so next coming to the here, see here, like a okay crest of ileum, if you want to give the injection to the thigh, so we have to divide the thigh in four partitions. Like I see here, so this is a okay buttocks. We have to divide the buttocks in four regions. So this is the left buttock, so this is the right buttock. So each buttock is divided into four partitions like this. So this is a place for the upper outer quadrant. Quadrant is nothing but one partition of the part. It's clear na? This is upper outer quadrant. Here also upper outer quadrant. Not, we should not give the injections. It may be down or inner also, we should not give. If you'll give inner, it may give the other problem will be there. If you want to give the injection to the buttocks, upper, first we have to divide the four partition of each buttock. We have to see the upper. See, this is upper. This is the lower. Okay, this is inner, this is the outer. It's clear na? So we should not give, this is wrong, this is wrong, this is wrong, this is the right upper outer quadrant. This is wrong, this is wrong, this is wrong, this is the right. It's clear na? Okay, upper outer quadrant landmarking by making a double cross is here. So this is the injection site, four and three way split board track method. It's clear na? Okay, okay, moderate large volume can be given but not more than 5 ml. Okay, only up to okay 5 ml we can give. Intramuscular injection work faster and systematic effect of the drug. Firstly, it will give the if you will give the injection, it will work faster. Okay, indications, some vaccines are administered intramuscularly. Okay, Gardasil hepatitis A vaccine. Okay, rabies vaccine, RABIS, rabies vaccine, influenza vaccines, okay, based on the inactivated viruses are commonly administered intramuscularly. Okay, platelet-rich plasma injections can be administered intramuscularly. Certain substances, ketamine for recreational purposes, okay, vitamin and B joys, okay, cyanocobalamin, okay, hydroxycholamine, NA or methylcobalamin. These are all the injections we can give into the IM route. Okay, contraindication. Contraindication is we should not give. Active infection near the site of injection, a known allergy, hypersensitive to the material or to the lidocaine. Acute myocardial infection like related to heart disease. Intramuscular injection leads to the release of muscle specific enzymes which complicate the elaborated diagnosis in mitochondrial infection. Shock, the blood supply to the peripheral is reduced, which means insecure absorption of the active substances. Coagulation disorders like a hemophilia or other therapies which anticoagulant risk of massive hematoma formation at the site. So this is all the who are having these complications, we should not give to the injections. Is clear now? Okay, see here. Okay, steps for IM injections. Okay, so steps for an IM injection. So know the type of drug needed, route of administered and dosage, drug handling precautions and adverse drug reactions and all. Okay, read. Okay, it's clear now. Read. Okay, so read the drug labeling. Use only sterile needles and syringes. Okay, untie the horse if you are not sure of this reaction. Insert the needle straight into the muscle and up to the bulb. Okay, attach the syringe to the needle. Aspirate again. When you are poke into the muscle of the body, again we have to aspirate. Why we have to aspirate? If you want to give the IM injection, when we will draw back, it may not, the blood may not be come. If any blood will come, no, the site is not in correct position. That is the reason again we have to stop giving the injections and we have to remove the syringes. It's clear na? Okay, so when you are poke into the muscle of the body, we have to aspirate. Okay, and on the plunger, if the blood appearance in the syringe, remove the needle and try again with a clean one. Slowly inject the medications. Observe the nurse for signs, observe reactions. Make sure you have okay epinephrine ready for injections. In case of anaphylactic shock, peripherally dispose of your needle and syringe in a medical waste container. Okay, after giving, we have to discard the syringes in the containers. Clean equipment needed to perform an IM injection. Syringe, SYRING syringe spelling mistakes will be there. 1 to 2 inches in length. Okay, medication to be administered, gloves, band-aid, alcohol, so banderols, no need. It's clear. Okay, this is the, okay, this is syringe injection. Okay, this is the shaft. This is a hole will be the bevel, shaft, okay, needle, hub, barrel, okay, plunger. This is all clear. Okay, next one is the here. Okay, so here procedure. So check the patient's name of medication order, including rights of administration of oral medication to the patient, right dose. So this is all the right patient. Okay, right patient, right dose, right drug, right time, right route, right assessment, right approach, right education, right nurse clinician, principle of care, right document. These are all the things we have to follow before giving any injection to the patient. So this is okay. So this is the way we have to give the injection. Okay, skin 90-degree angle like this we have to hold and we have to give the injections to the patients. Is clear now? Okay, so next one is the advantages of intramuscular injection: rapid onset for action, uniform absorption, long duration of action, suitable for vaccine. Okay, so giving an IM injection into the deltoid site. If you want to give the injection to the hand, so find the knobby top of the arm, process know the border of an inverted triangulized finger widths down from the acromion process. Okay, so stretch the skin and then bunch up the muscle inside the needle of the right angle to the skin in the center of the inverted triangle. Educate client about medications. Educate the client on medication self-administration procedures. Okay, next, prepare and administer medications using rights of medication administration. Review patients' data prior to medication administration. Contraindications, lab results, allergies, potential interactions we have to see. And if the patient having any those complications, we can avoid giving the IM injections. It's clear. General nurse duties: conduct physical exams, take detailed health care histories, listen the patients, analyze their physical emotional needs, provide counseling and health care education to patients, coordinate care with other health care professionals. 6 C's: care, compassion, courage, communication, commitment, competence are essential plank of compassion in the patients. It's clear now? Okay, if the hand will be there, no, for example, this hand will be there. Already I have told, no, if you want to give the buttock, so we have divided the buttock is each two partitions. Again, each buttock is divided 4 partitions. If you want to give the injection to the hand, so here this is known as acromion process. So here we have to give the 4 fingers. After placing the 4 fingers, first this is the process called as acromion process. In this acromion process, when we want to place the 4 fingers of the acromion process of your shoulder, after placing the 5th place here, it will be there. No? So here we have to give the IM injections. So this is the site for the IM injections to the arm. This is known as a deltoid. If you want to give the, if you will give the injections to the arm, it is known as a deltoid. If you want to give the injection to the buttock, it is known as a gluteal. Gluteal maximus. This is deltoid muscles. Is clear now? Okay. Okay, next one is the calculating dose. If you want, you can make it. Otherwise, no need. This is the for BS nursing level. So, no need of writing. No need of you people. So, next coming to the. So, actually, the question is the administration. Write the different routes of drug administration, and one more question also, procedure of IM injections. So till now I discussed the procedure of IM injections. Next, in that first question is the administration of drugs. So here you can write a drug also called as a medicine, defined as a medicine, defined as an any chemical substance intended for use in the medical diagnosis, care or cure, treatment or prevention of disease. Okay. Medications can be classified in various ways, such as by chemical properties made or okay, route of administration, biological system affected or therapeutic effects. An elaborate and widely used classification is the anatomical therapeutic chemical classification system, ATC system will be there. Okay, anatomical therapeutic chemical classification, it's clear na? Okay, sampling of okay, masses of medicine includes antipyretics, analgesics, based on the action of the medicine into our body. It is based on that. The medications are divided into different classifications, like antipyretics, analgesics, anti-malaria, antibiotics, antiseptics. Okay, antipyretics, it will reduce the fever. Analgesics, it will reduce pain. Anti-malaria, it is treating malaria. Antibiotics, it will inhibit the growth of the okay bacteria. Next, antiseptics, prevention of germs growth near burns, cuts and wounds. Okay, forms of drugs, so no need to
for this. Mama.
Okay. Okay, administration of drugs, you can want, you can write it. Okay, types. Okay, this points you can write. Oral, in oral, pills, tablets, capsules, specifically tablet like buccal, sublingual or orally disintegrating thin film. Okay, Listerine. Okay, pocket packs, liquid solution or suspension, powder or liquid or solid crystals, natural herbal plant, seed or feed of sorts. Okay, these are all special bronches, paste and coagulate inhalations. Okay, in this you can oral, liquid form, okay, paste and inhalations. Okay, nebulizers, smoking often in a natural herb. Okay, these are all things. It's clear na? Okay. Vaporizer, parenteral injections, not than oral, it is known as the parenteral, intradermal, intramuscular, intraosseous, intraperitoneal, intravenous, subcutaneous, topical, cream, gel, lintment, ointment, balm, lotion. Okay, topical cream, gel, and lintment. Okay, this eye drops, ophthalmic skin patch, transdermal, vaginal rings, suppositories, rectal, vaginal, these are all things you can write it. Okay, next question is the explain the principles, uses and types of bandages. Bandaging is the process of covering a wound or an injured parts. Bandages are used for following purposes: to prevent contamination of wound by holding dressings in position, to provide support to the part that is injured, sprained or dislocated joint, to provide rest to the part that is injured, to prevent control bleed, hemorrhage, to restrict movement, immobilize a fracture or dislocation, to correct deformity, to maintain a pressure. Okay, types of bandages: strangler bandage, roller bandage, special bandages. Materials commonly used for bandages: flannel, cotton, cotton gauze and jute. Okay, you can take a screenshot and you can write it. This is the section 1 last question. Okay, wool, special materials like crepe bandages, elastic bandage and domestic materials, etc. So parts of roller bandage: head, free end and tail. Parts: triangular of bandage, point, end. Okay, sizes of bandage: the size of the bandage varies according to the part it is supposed to bandage. Part to be damaged: width, height, heated trunk by leg, fingers, hand, wrist. Okay, width, the fingers. How much width should be there? Okay, fingers, hand, wrist. Okay, 510 to 156, 85 to 62. Okay, so if you don't want to write this also, but we have tried, these general principles are very, very important. Select a bandage of hand. Excuse me. So general principles are very, very important. You have to, don't forget to write. Select a bandage of proper size, suitable material. Put the patient in a comfortable position. Support the injured area while managing. Okay, if a joint is involved, flex it slightly. Face the patient while applying the bandage, except the applying it into the head. Okay, pad bony prominence. Hold the roll of the bandage in the right hand and the right hand when applying bandage on the left side. Hold the bandage with the roll uppermost and apply the outer surface of the skin. Okay, unrolling a few centimeters of the bandage at a time. Put some cotton wool on the part of the bandage so that the bandage does not slip, cause cutting into the skin underneath. Okay, bandage firm below upward and firm within outward. Okay. Hold the end of the bandage over the outer aspects of the injured area and wind the bandage around the part twice to fix it. When bandaging the limb, start with an oblique turn to keep the bandage in a position as an alternative method. So cover 2/3 of the bandage by the next one. While covering a large area by winding the roller bandage around the part, keep the edges parallel. Keep even and not too tight pressure while applying the bandage. Too tight bandage interferes with circulation. It should not tight too tight or too loose. Okay, finish with a straight line and fix the end with a soft safety pin. Okay, sticking faster or by dividing the terminal portion of the bandage longitudinally. Okay, typing the two ends around the bandaging part. If possible, leave fingers and toes exposed to check circulation. Do not bandage the part too tightly or too loosely. Observe the extremities carefully. Any signs of swelling or blueness due to interference. Okay, so these are all the things you can write it. Following terms are used in total bandages. If you want, you can write it. This not otherwise, you can write like introduction bandages. Introduction, definition, types and principles. You can write it. If you want, you can write otherwise. You can avoid these points. Okay, types of slings also will be there. If you want, you can write it. Otherwise, you can avoid this content also. Splints will always, it will support the part of the fractured limb. Okay, these points you can write it, ma. Okay, these points about nursing care for patients there. Okay, treated with the splints. You can write nursing care before application of the splint. Take concern, inform the patient about the procedure, remove only tight fitting clothes and change them into easy to wear dresses. So these are all the points you can write. Remaining, no need to write. This is for BS nursing level, I have given these notes. But okay, nursing care after the application of the splints, all points also you can write it. Okay, next, I completed section 1, all the questions. Section B, hand washing procedure. Okay, to clean the hands to minimize cross infection to each patient, self, and in the environment for anesthetic sense. Okay, requirement soap in soap dish, sink it put with the tap. Okay, next, TAP tap, not top. Okay, towel, nail brush, nail cutter. Nail brush, nail cutter. Nail file or nail brush, a container with disinfected paper space and all, and washing procedure. So these points you can write. If I explain now, the video may be too lengthy, so I'm stopping explaining. Just you can write these points. Second question is the patient with the pressure points. Next question is the patients with the pressure points. Decubitus ulcer also known as pressure sores, pressure ulcers. These points we can add it. These points you can write it. Prevention of pressure. This is a very, very important question for theory purpose also. Very, very important questions. Treatment of the decubitus ulcer, signs and symptoms of pressure sores. So these points you can write it. प्रोसीजर ओके दिस पॉइंट्स यू कैन राइट इट मैम नेक्स्ट वन प्रोसीजर्स दिस पॉइंट्स यू कैन ऐड इट नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन आर्टिकल्स ऑफ फर्स्ट एड किट बॉक्स होम एंड ट्रैवल फर्स्ट एड किट बॉक्स बेसिक्स वाई वी हैव टू कैरी व्हाट इज द इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ फर्स्ट एड किट बॉक्स कॉमन आइटम्स व्हाट आर द कॉमन आइटम्स शुड बी देयर इन फर्स्ट एड किट बॉक्स फॉर व्हाट पर्पस विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस आइटम्स व्हाट आर द कंडीशंस we may give the treatment we can use for reducing the fever cold and cough and sometimes some instruments and equipments also we should carry into the first aid kit box medications also will be there drugs ointments and all okay so till now I completed the okay one more last topic is that the wound care so I will show you that topic also this last question not last question in this question also should be there in the practical recording section to in PHN for the first year students okay wound care and for types of wounds and explain briefly about the wound care. This is the definition of the wound. Wound is a type of physical trauma and where the integrity of the skin or of any tissue is compromised. It's a separation or discontinuation of the skin mucous membrane or tissue caused by physical, chemical and biological insult. Okay, wound classification. Wound classification systems provide framework that a diagnosis and stratification ensure uniformity of documentations, offer prognostic information, guide management. Types of wound classifications. Table wise you can make it okay according to the duration of the wound healing acute wounds and chronic acute wounds are wounds that usually heal in the anticipated time frame duration of the wound immediately to few minutes or few weeks okay acute is nothing but the duration of the wound immediately to few weeks it will occur it is known as acute wounds okay next chronic is a 4 weeks to 3 months okay 4 weeks to 3 months it will happen the wound it like 4 weeks to 3 months it is known as a chronic wounds it may be like peptic ulcers venous leg ulcers and diabetic foot ulcers are examples of these chronic wounds okay according to the integrity of the skin open wounds and closed wounds open wound types of wound in which the skin has been compromised underlying tissues are exposed if the tissues are exposed it is known as the tissues are exposed it is known as the open wounds okay next coming to the closed wounds so structures as occurred closed wounds have fewer categories but are just as dangerous as open wounds okay contusions the closed wounds are again classified into contusions and hematoma more commonly known as a bruise caused by the blunt force trauma that damages tissue under the skin it will damages the skin damages tissue under the skin hematoma calls a blood tumor caused by damage to the blood vessel that in turn causes blood collect the causes blood to collect under the skin okay so according to wound depth superficial wounds only the epidermis is affected and has to be replaced only epidermis okay partial thickness wounds does bleed if left uncovered a blood clot will cover the wound and a scar will form partial thickness will be there full thickness wound involve the epidermis and the dermis underlying fatty tissue bones muscles and tendons may also be damaged is known as a full thickness wounds okay it may be longer time to heal than does know a partial thickness wound sometimes as long as several months also it will take okay next according to severity simple wounds the integrity of the skin is traumatized without loss or destruction of tissue and without the presence of a foreign body in the wound simple wounds complex wounds tissue is lost or destructed by me. Means of a crush, bone or foreign body in that wound. So this is we are calling as a complex wound healing. So wound healing is a wound repair is a body's natural process of restoring normal function and structure after injury. Phases of wound healing. Three phases of the inflammatory phase, proliferative phase, maturation and remodeling phase. So management of wounds. Surgical toilet with a primary closure, delayed closure. So delayed closure is again three types. So delayed primary closure, skin grafting and plaits. Okay, wound dressing and skin grafting and plaits. Depends upon the condition of the wounds. So the treatment will be, variations will be there. Okay, so these are types of wounds. Abrasions, lacerations, avulsion, incision, puncture, amputation. Okay, the wound management cycle. Healed, start with patient, identify wound etiology, perform time assessment and agree clear goals, treat and evaluate time interventions. Okay, this is the management cycle. Okay, this is the management. Okay, the types of wounds. Types of wounds: cut, stab, stab and cut, torn, bitten, chopped, crush, hurt, firearms, scalp, surgery and poison. Okay, so next one is a wound. Okay, wound healing. Okay, hemostasis, inflammatory, proliferative, remodeling. This is the process of the wound healing. Okay, size of the wounding, bleeding, inflammation, proliferation and remodeling. So this is the steps or stages how the wound will be going to heal in the period. Okay, so till now I completed the overall the primary health care nursing section 1, section 2 questions for the MPHW first year students in the subject of the primary health care nursing. Okay, thanks for watching my channel. If the video is lengthy, but try to understand and try to take out the screenshot, and you can make it the screenshot for writing the practical record for you people. Okay, so thanks for watching my channel. Have a nice day.